better hit that subscribe button.
What is going on, ladies and gentlemen of the internet and YouTube? I'm FredEFuego, Flaming Hot Entertainment, MultiplatGameTrap.com, the people's voice, and your favorite average gamer. This is the PlayStation Vita review. All right, I'm going to take you through the steps, show you through the user interface, how well it responds, the screen. The screen cannot be done justice by any photography, any video photography. You have to see this for yourself. So go out to your local GameStop, go to your Best Buy, any place where they have this on display, and go look at it for yourself. You at least deserve to look at the screen by yourself. This is the Flickr app. I'm just going to go through some of these apps real quick. The apps are pretty much intuitive. They work pretty fast. They can somewhat guess what you want to do, so that's why I say it's intuitive. The buttons, everything, the layout is very thought of to make it simple, minimize it. Here is Facebook. The Facebook app has been taken off the PlayStation Store because of Facebook servers are so slow, jam-packed. It was just server crashes and stuff like that when everybody was downloading this. And it is laggy, even with not many people having the app. It is still laggy and very slow to boot up. And just showing you how it is for y'all that didn't get the chance to download the app before they took it off the PlayStation Store. You're not really missing anything. Facebook is better done on iPhone, Android phone, and stuff like that. It's very lackluster, to say the least. Anyways, this is my Facebook page, and this is for MultiplatGameTrap.com. This is the Facebook page. I don't have a personal Facebook page. I don't use Facebook, but I have everybody that knows me on Facebook on here or whatever. And you can see all the news feed, the friends, the messaging. The messaging works good. You know, your home, your notifications, all that good stuff. So, if you see any pixelation on the screen, it just happens to be because I'm recording it off a video camera. Now, let's go into the Tweet app. Live Tweet is my favorite app for Twitter for any platform on any device. This is my favorite Twitter app ever. And, I just like the way it looks. I like the blue and white. I like how responsive it is, how everything is. I love the keyboard, the virtual keyboard on the Vita. I like how well it just works with Twitter, integration on everything. I give this is a perfect way to put an app on the PlayStation Vita. This is how all apps should work, respond. The only thing that's wrong with the PlayStation Vita, you cannot see YouTube videos because it doesn't have mobile flash. Sorry, mobile flash pretty much is dead. It's going to be phased out of all of mobile devices. So hopefully they get the HTML working. HTML5 working for everything, and it becomes integrated and patched for the PlayStation Vita. There is all the little side things I'm showing you right here, the count settings and all that stuff. And you could actually scroll up and down on the left hand side, push it up and down and go back. You're going to see that I pull it back down and go back to the tweets. And I'm just going to end up tweeting saying, hey, I'm recording this video for the PlayStation Vita review. And tweet it out straight from the Vita. Anyways, I like to see a YouTube app because we have all the other apps. We just need a YouTube app for the PS Vita. The web browser needs to be patched up, overhauled or something because it does not render everything completely. It just renders what's showing, and then when you move it around, sometimes it gets messed up and it is. I don't like using the web browser on it. Just I have used it, but I don't like using it. It just doesn't work like it should. It is. It's definitely a miss on design. All right. I was gonna show you some other stuff. Oh yeah, the friends list. The friends list shows you your friends, and if they have a PlayStation Vita and they've gone to their settings and put a little panel up there, that actually sets your PSN ID. It has like a little drawing on the right hand side. You see on the top of mine have it's red and black, and it has some drawings and stuff like that. And then you see the little banana, a monkey in the banana, for DJ Sponge 10. And that basically just tells somebody that was, they have a Vita because they made their panel. And I'm just showing you like that right there and right there. So you could tell people who have a Vita and who haven't. And hopefully, you know, everybody that has a Vita gone into their settings and go into their PlayStation Network settings and put a panel on their ID. So when you're on your Vita, people know that, you know, you have a Vita. All right. This is the near function. The near function is the next evolution in social gaming, where if you walk by people and stuff like that and they have certain items in a game, you can download it from them. It gives you so much time before it is expires. And I downloaded the Gold Wolverine for Ultimate Marvel versus Capcom 3 from Sarge, somebody on my friends list, and, you know, just people that I walk by. Some games I do own, some I don't. And it's pretty cool because I ain't got to sit there and unlock any, you know, go through the game to unlock it or anything like that. Then it lets you go through your friends and let you see, you know, what they've been doing and this is out and about, you know, what people have been playing. But when you see them on your thing, it does a 2 mile radius. That see, it says 1 mile, 2 mile, the outer ring, and it does do a 2 mile radius of where you're at. You could actually make, I'm gonna blur that out around where I live at, and you could actually make a private setting so where you can make a 2 mile radius where people don't know who you are or whatever. And especially where I live at, I just put a private setting for a 2 mile bubble around me. Nobody can see who I am or anything like that, and it's just basically for privacy issues. And I suggest anybody that does that, you know what I'm saying, if you want people up in your house knowing that you got a Vita and stuff, and you could actually see myself through there. And this is basically like the activity of my friends. I could give them a thumb up, I could comment, and it just shows their activity. And I could do that. That's my boy Jay Sleek. And then the discoveries is what I just shown you. I showed you the out and about. And the settings. The settings, of course. Data location. Privacy. Privacy is where you can do that 2 mile radius privacy bubble, so people don't know who you are and stuff like that. But once you go outside of that bubble, you can see privacy zones. One, I have one privacy zone around my house. And then distance, miles, and it has kilometers. And I was just going to show you. That's it. Anyways, I like a lot of things about the Vita, but there's things that I don't like about the Vita. The Vita's certain, if you buy a used game or rent a used game and the person did not, I don't know exactly how this works. I'm kind of noobish at that. But there's some type of thing where you can't get any trophies. And I don't understand how that works. So if you do, just leave it in the comment section below. And I think this is just to deter. And I just raised the screen by holding on the PlayStation button and pulling the screen brightness up. And that's another feature for if you're playing games and stuff like that and send the screen brightness, just hold down the PlayStation button. And these are the Vita trophies. And then on the top right hand, you're going to see that it has PlayStation trophies too. And you can see all the PlayStation trophies, and they got the platinums and all that good stuff. You can sync the server, which I did right here. And then you have sorting the trophies into different categories. And I'm going to do it by updated progress or whatever. I'm going to do updated, boom. And it's just going to chase how I do it and everything. And like I said, you got gold, platinum trophies, silver, and bronze. This is the messaging system. The messaging system basically messages, like, you know, you get on the PlayStation, your PlayStation or your Xbox or whatever. You do get double messages if you have a PlayStation, and they'll come both to your PlayStation if you're using the same ID. So they'll go to both all the systems unless you delete them before you turn on your PS3. So then you won't get them on the PS3. Anyways, but that just shows the messages, and that's the message system. The message system also lets you create messages and lets you set when it updates your push, you know, pushes the update every 1 hour, 30 minutes, 15 minutes, or you could just turn it off. And then this is where you create a brand new message, which is done really good. Like I said, the only thing that I wish they had was a home Wi-Fi setting, so they wouldn't lock, it wouldn't keep kicking you off the network and stuff like that, so that it could always be online. Just showing you the bubbles and all the games, and I actually, they're kind of awkward and they take up a lot of space, but they work for it. Remote play doesn't really work on the PlayStation Vita for the most part. Hopefully they patch that soon. I have a US PlayStation Vita and it does not work. Photos, Netflix is great. What's that? Videos is okay. The content manager, I like the content manager, but it's kind of slow to transfer everything. The data speeds are, our transfer speeds are slow. The web browser, iffish. I like maps. The welcome park lets you figure out everything. And this is going into the PlayStation Store. It shows you all the featured items. And you go into there and basically that's for the codes from your, you know, if you buy a PSN card or you have a, you know, I'm saying a gift code or something like that. That's where you put it in. You type in, it's a three-tier, four-digit number. So it ends up being 12 alphanumeric things. And basically that's where you put it in and then you get your, you redeem it right there. These are the features and the games and all that stuff. And it says like PS Minis, apps, demos, media, and by genre. And then you have the four categories up top. Top downloads, new releases, and featured. Which you can scroll through all of them. It very loads up very quickly. Like I said, the only thing that doesn't take loading fast is the web browser. And I don't even want to go through it because it is a fail in my opinion. This is the chat. This is the party chat. The party chat feature is great. You can make a party chat where you can invite a friend and their friends can jump in. Or you can make it a private party chat where, you know, you make a party chat and it's by invite only. And not even your friends can invite somebody else. I'm not too sure of that. But I'm sure it's just the person who made the party can invite. Then you can change the party name. Right there. That's how you create it. And then, you know, friends of friends or invite players only. And then you can change the name. And I always put multiplatgametrap.com. And you see it right there. Boom. And it does remember what the, you know, some things that you use in text. Predictive text. And the keyboard on this is awesome compared to the PSP. And you just create one and I just put friends of friends and then you can invite people by the right there, by that right there, pressing that and inviting people. And seeing that I have a little panel right there, it lets me know if they have a PlayStation Vita. It's very easy because I do use the same account for my PS3 and my PlayStation Vita. And it does allow up to 8 people, unlike the PS3 is 6 people, but it does not allow video chat. It's just voice chat. And then you can leave it, and there you go. Then it shows, you know, if one of my friends were on there, it would show his party chat in there. Holding the PS button will show those little blades, and then, you know, I'll just turn it off, showing you those are the speakers right there. They're to the right and the left-hand side of the analog sticks, which if you're using the analog stick, your finger really goes, your thumbs actually go over them, and it's kind of weird because then you're muzzling out the sound. There goes the camera. There goes the D-pad, the buttons, and they are very tactile. They get great tactile feedback. Here is the back panel. It is very nicely done. It feels like glass. Those are where you hold your fingers at right there when you're holding it the right way. And right here is the where you slide in the game cartridge, and I'm taking it out right now, showing it to you. That's Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3, and it does install some game save on game install onto the game when you first put it in. And be aware that if you do buy a PlayStation Vita used game, there might be a way that you don't get trophies on it. I still, like I said, I don't know. I just found out about that, so I'm still researching that. I don't have two PlayStation Vitas to test out the theories myself, so I'm just trying to wait until you see the little light pop on when you put the game in and stuff like that, and the PlayStation Vita's on. This is an accessory port. It looks sort of like it has little screw parts like the PSP, where you can actually screw an accessory on top of it, like the camera. The volume rockers are on the top. That's how it looks on the side. It looks like brushed metal, but it isn't. It is a plastic with some type of glossy coating over it. That is the SIM card if you have the 3G model. And the camera and all that good stuff. And it just very nice. Here goes the memory card slot. And it's right there, right next to, in between. I pull it off right here. I'm going to turn it off. And then pull it out and show you the memory card slot. That's the memory card. And it is very, very, very tiny. About the size of my thumbnail. And that's a 4 gig. And they're all the same size. It goes 4 gig, 8 gig, 16, and 32 gig memory cards is what they have. So they double in size. And I was putting it in the wrong way. You have the right next to my thumb, you have the 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. Then you have the microphone, which is right there, the memory, the headphone jack. And then the power cable goes right there, which is, it's a proprietary port. And it goes into USB 2.0, which goes into the power brick, or it could go into your computer and you could power it up through your computer. See how much, it's a fingerprint magnet. I'm just showing you it's a fingerprint magnet. But it is very nice. It's like a first generation PS3 in the palm of your hand with a nice screen on it. All right, now I'm going to bring in the PlayStation Vita first edition carrying case. This is what it comes with. You could put four PlayStation Vita games in there, five in total, because you could have one in your PlayStation Vita. That is for like the power cable or whatever like that. I'm going to show you by putting some, they do fit the AR cards in there. You can fit the AR cards, and then I'm gonna put the cable in there and show you how nice it fits. And then right now I'm just grabbing the cable, and I'm gonna bump the camera in a second. anyways, it fits really nice. It's nice, and it's a hard case, so it's hard shelled. Even though it has like a pleathery finish to it, it's very nice. You can't buy it anywhere. I tried looking for them. You can't buy this particular one anywhere. That's why I wanted the first edition bundle. Plus, I got it a week early and got to give you all the content that y'all grown to love on my channel. And there you go. It fits right in there. You know what I'm saying? You could still put something, a case over the PlayStation Vita, and it'll still fit right in there, like a silicone case over it. It's very hard. It's hard-backed right there. And very... I like that. It's small enough to fit a lot of things, and it's big enough to hold in your hand or to put somewhere, and you know if it's there or not. I give the Vita an 8 out of 10 score. I hope you enjoyed the review.
I've been your host, FredEFuego, Flamin' Hot Entertainment, MultiplatGameTrap.com. If you enjoyed this review, remember to hit that thumbs up button, subscribe, you get all my videos in your inbox. If not, just stay tuned to my channel, you'll catch all my videos. And I appreciate it. Leave your comments for this review. This was a review on the PlayStation Vita and the first edition bundle. And I will have the written review on transcripted on my website, multiplatgametrap.com. If you hover above the little coffee cups on my channel, you'll be taken to the respected icon links that are on the coffee cups. And the Multiplat Game Trap, if you hover above that, you go straight to my website. So stay tuned for more reviews, unboxings, tech news, news in gaming and music, independent. Been your host, your commentator, FredEFuego, Flamin' Hot Entertainment, MultiplatGameTrap.com. The people's voice and your favorite average gamer. Peace, love, and hair grease. Haters keep on hating. If you haven't been doing it, you need to get gaming.
Thumb up the video, fool!